This video shows patch budding. This method of grafting citrus trees is very easy and it gives a high success rate. It works well for adding new varieties to an existing tree. In order to achieve a successful graft and also to avoid spreading disease, I sterilize my grafting tools with a 1.5% concentration of chlorine bleach. It's easiest to cut the patch from a round part of a bud stick. I press the knife into the bud stick until I feel it stop by the wood, and then I turn the bud stick all the way around. It's best to make the second cut so that there's more than one bud on the patch. Next, I cut along the scion between the circular cuts. The bark lifter on this knife makes it easy to peel the patch off of the bud stick. The patch can also be cut from an angular-shaped scion, but it is more of a challenge, as I will show in the second example. Citrus cuttings have the potential to spread tree-killing diseases. It is often not apparent when a tree is infected with a fatal disease. This makes the source of citrus budwood for grafting very important. In California, where I live, we now have both exotic diseases that kill citrus trees and also the insects that spread the diseases. The situation is so severe that it is now against the law in California to graft with backyard citrus cuttings. Hobbyists in California now instead order their budwood at a nominal cost from the Citrus Clonal Protection Program, or CCPP, a program that exists to provide disease-free budwood for the grafting of citrus trees. I've made a video that shows how to set up an account and order citrus budwood. You can click here or on the link below. The CCPP will ship budwood anywhere in the world where the local laws allow it. Many citrus-growing regions where it's not allowed have their own disease-free citrus budwood programs. Information on other programs is included in the ordering video. To prepare the target branch to receive the graft, I place the patch on the target branch and use it as a guide to make cuts below and above where the patch will be grafted to the target branch. The distance between the first two cuts does not need to be precise. The patch will fit the target branch more easily if the distance between the cuts is a little bit larger than the length of the patch. Next, I make a third perpendicular cut joining the ends of the first two cuts. I use the bark lifter for my grafting knife to peel the bark back, and then I cut the bark to make room for the patch. Next, I place the patch onto the target branch, lining up the patch on the bottom and on one side. I wrap the graft tightly to ensure contact of the cambium layers. The cambium touching cambium is slippery and it helps to hold the bud to keep it from slipping while wrapping it. Vinyl tape makes a good wrapping material because it is possible to stretch it and wrap it very tightly without breaking it. I wrap the graft with aluminum foil to protect it from the sun and to keep it from getting too hot and drying out. After a 3-week healing period, I remove both the aluminum foil and also the vinyl tape. A phenomenon called apical dominance governs the growth of citrus buds. Natural hormones from the buds at the end of the branches prevent buds lower down from growing. In order for the grafted bud to grow, the effect of these hormones must be overcome. The first step to overcoming apical dominance is to cut off approximately 2/3 of the branch above the patch bud. The second step to overcoming apical dominance is to remove a portion of the bark above the bud. I cut a notch halfway around the branch. The bark on the opposite side of the branch from the bud is left intact. Of the many citrus patch bud grafts I performed last year, most of them were very slow to start growing. The graft in this video of a Mato Buntan pummelo was the first to start growing. The growth here started within a few months of unwrapping the graft. I performed the grafts in late spring, and most of them waited until early spring the next year to start growing. I got impatient and pruned off the rest of the branch sooner than I should have. If the graft grows too quickly without support, it could break off at the graft union. To strengthen the graft, it is better to tie it to the remainder of the target branch. After the graft grows and the graft union strengthens, the remainder of the target branch can be removed. Patch budding of citrus is easy and gives a high success rate, but compared to scion grafts, patch buds can be slow to grow. In addition to this video, you can find a step-by-step guide to patch budding citrus at fruitmentor.com/patchbudding. Here's what the pummelo graft looked like the next spring. Here's a patch bud of an Avani Tardivo Mandarin Orange starting to grow. I have made this video to save citrus trees all over the world from deadly diseases. You can help by sharing this video, by giving it a thumbs up, and by subscribing to this YouTube channel. Another thing you can do to save citrus trees is to keep ants off of them. Ants protect harmful pests from predators so that they can harvest the sugary honeydew produced by the pests. I've made some videos to help you to keep ants off of your trees. Please check them out. I've written an ebook with tips to help you graft citrus successfully. It also includes tips on grafting cocktail trees. You can download it for free at fruitmentor.com/graftingtips.